Hello, Academy of Holy Names. How are you guys doing?
Great.
Good. I am Jason Latimer. I will be your teacher for today. I have something I want to see if I can work through the screen. Now, this is an illusion, but hopefully it will work through the screen. I'm going to show you a handful of cards. I want you to memorize one of them. In your mind, don't tell your neighbor. Do you see one card? Okay, now I'm going to take a look through here, and using my science powers, I think this is your card. That's right, this one is your card. I'm gonna place it over here. Did I get it right? Is your card missing?
Yeah.
This week, the Academy of the Holy Names in Tampa, Florida invited Impossible Science to come into their classroom. Let's check it out.
I'll tell you what, let me show you a way to use mathematics to fool ourselves. I need everybody to grab a suit of cards, okay? Doesn't matter which suit you have, you just need to have ace on the top, all the way down to the king on the bottom in order, okay? Well, I'm gonna show you a secret move, but if you follow these steps, we'll blow our own minds. Here's the move. I'm gonna ask you to spell out numbers, all right? And what we're gonna do for every letter that we spell, you have to use one card from the top and put it to the bottom. So let's say I said spell the ace. It would be A, C, E, right? Make sense? Or if I said king or jack or seven, you're actually spelling the word seven. Does that make sense? When we get started, everyone's gonna end up with different cards on top. So don't look at your neighbor's cards because they're gonna be different than yours. So I'm gonna ask you to be thinking of a card right now. You got one in your mind? Think of the value, ace, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, jack, queen, or king, all right? And then I want you to spell that value of that card, one letter for every card from top to the bottom. So go ahead and do that right now. You got it? All right, now take a peek at the top card. All right, look at that card. Whatever value you have on top, spell that card, moving one card from the top to the bottom for every letter, okay? Now take another peek at the top card. Whatever number that is, I want you to spell that card next. One letter for every card. Here we go. Now, everybody started with their own number in their head. Everyone got to make their choices through this, so nobody really knows what's going on. But I need a volunteer. I need somebody to help me on this one. Gabriella, I saw your hand go up first. All right, Gabriella, as team leader, I need you to come up with any number that you like. Ace through king. Number five. Okay, everybody, this time we're gonna count the number five all together from the top to bottom. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, everybody take your top card and face it towards the screen right now.
What?
No,
no, no,
no,
no,
no,
no,
no,
I don't believe
it.
I don't believe
it. Now you're probably wondering, how does that work? Well, I've got good news for you. I've got the man who created this effect as a special guest today. That's right, Alain Nu, who created this effect based off of the work of Jim Steinmeier's 1 o'clock mystery. Now, Alain is actually the star of the show The Man Who Knows in Las Vegas. And Alain's gonna show us how this mind reading trick works. Alain, thank you so much for joining me on the show.
I'm so excited to be here.
Now, Alain, your effect, it was mind-blowing to see everybody just hold up their cards at the screen. It was fantastic, and I just thought, I have to talk to you about this effect. Can you give us any tips or secrets about what's going on with the mathematics towards the foundation of the 1 o'clock mystery?
There's only a limited amount of choices that you have, given that, for instance, ace and two have the same number of letters in the spelling of those values, and you have four and five each have four letters 7 and 3 and queen would all have 5. And so it's all going to be variables of what seems to be 13 different choices, but it's really only a choice of like 3. It's only 3, 4, and 5 that they get to move from. And then from there, it just kind of weirdly works itself out because of the genius of Jim Steinmeier.
And it does make it interesting because you feel like you have all these different choices. What would be one of your favorite illusions that could work through the screen?
So I'll tell you what, for this demonstration, I'm going to only need you to get 7 cards. That would be the ace through 7 and of different suits. And in fact, I see that they're in order. So do me a favor and shuffle those up. And that way they're in no particular order. You can shuffle them up off camera. That way I can't even see how you're shuffling.
So, all right. Okay, here we go. All right, I'm done.
Okay, so now I'm going to kind of just take you through a maneuvering process with the cards. That'll be very simple. Since you've got the cards facing you, find the 2, whichever suit that is, it doesn't matter, but find the 2 and bring that so that it's at the face of that little spread facing you. And so in the spirit of the last demonstration that we were talking about, I'm gonna have you spell the word 2, 1 card for each letter as you move from the 2, take the 2 and move it to the back of the cards, and that would be T, and then take the next card that follows the 2, whatever that is, and we'll call that W, and then the last one, O, would be, you just move it behind there. So now we've got 3 cards moved to the back. And let's do that with the 3. Just spread through, find the 3, cut the 3 to the very face, and then spell 3 in the same way that you spelled 2. I'll tell you what. Take the top and bottom card of the packet that you've got and eliminate them. Just put them over to the side, and that way I don't even know what remaining 5 cards you have. So now whether that card that's facing you right now is a 4 or not, spell 4, moving 1 card for each letter. And then I'll tell you what, take the top and bottom of the pack that you're holding and put the top and bottom card over to the side, eliminating them with the rest. And then take those last cards, turn them face down so you can't even see them. And then take the top and bottom card of that packet and put it over to the side, eliminating those.
Okay.
So at this point, you are left with 1 card, and you don't even see it. You don't even know what it is, right?
No.
So let me see if I can somehow figure out what it is. I'm gonna say I'm feeling like a black card. I'm sensing it's not a spade. I think it's the 3-leaf clover. It's the clubs, and I'm sensing it's the 3 of clubs. Is it the 3 of clubs? Show the camera right now.
What?
Look at that. Look at that. The 3 of clubs. How did you do that?
That is great. Wow. That is a great effect. Alain, it's great to have you on the show. Keep coming with those great illusions. Send them our way. We love hearing from you. And thank you so much. Again, you're amazing. Keep it going.
Absolutely. It's so good hanging out with you, Jason, always.
And thank you so much for having me in your classroom today. You guys have been a fantastic audience. And don't forget, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.